So she had a name. Maybe that was always her name. I don't know. She had a name. And the people them call her that name and call her that name, and maybe the name get corrupt. It's not that she was being disrespected by her body parts. What a European lens to look at the something by. Because when we call people by their body parts, it's not necessarily disrespectful.
One of the reasons why I would like not to be working with these people, because I believe it is possible. When the Taino came here, they made it clear to us that it's not a breast lick off.
That's right.
It's so it stays. Okay? And because she appeared with this one breast, the village has called her One Bubby Susan. But it's not that she's one Bubby, it's so people draw her. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
So that to call her One Bubby distorts the history.
Okay. So the village developed a way of describing that physical representation based on a misdiagnosis.
Okay. Okay.
I'd never heard that part of it. So I never thought a breast was missing. I never thought a breast was missing. I just think that have one breast. Some of us have 12 fingers. Have one breast. I never got that. Okay, thanks. Okay. Okay. Folk entomology.
Okay. And you see, that's the power of something like the Peace and Dignity Journey.
Yeah, it's very educational.
That can only help us. We can only grow from it.